Hello friends, myself Yadav Bhavesh. I am from DCC, Deep Coaching Classes. आज मैं जो आपको बताने जा रहा हूँ वो Standard 12 Chemistry Unit 2 Solution. Now what you mean by the solution? Solution की definition क्या है? Solution is the mixtures of two or more than two components and this mixture is homogeneous. So we can say that the solution is the homogeneous mixtures of two or more than two components. Let's see solutions. Solutions are homogeneous mixtures of two or more than two components. Now what do you mean by the homogeneous mixtures? Homogeneous mixtures means its compositions and properties are uniform throughout the mixtures. For example, we take water plus salt and we obtain solution of water plus salt. Now this solution is homogeneous mixtures because the properties and compositions are uniform throughout the mixtures. So we can say that homogeneous mixtures means its composition and property are uniform throughout mixtures. Now in the solution, what you mean by the solvent and what you mean by the solute? In the solution, the largest quantity is solution. For example, in this solution, water is the solvent. And what you mean by the solute? The other than solvent in the solution is known as the solute. For example, in this solution, the salt is the solute. Now we take some types of solutions and then them common example. Let's see the types of the solutions. In the solutions, solutes are maybe more than one, but in this chapter we study only the binary solution. It means the solvent is one and solute is also one. Types of the solutions. When in the solution where the solvent is gas, then it is known as the gaseous solution. The common example of gaseous solution, when the solvent is gas, solute is also gas. Mixtures of oxygen and nitrogen. Second example, gaseous solution, when solvent is gas and solute is liquid. Chloroform when dissolved in nitrogen gas. Third example, solvent is gas and solute is solid. Then common example, camphor dissolved in N2. The second types of the solution is the liquid solution. When the solvent is liquid, then the solution is known as the liquid solution. The common example of liquid solution, when the solvent is liquid and solute is gas. Oxygen dissolving H2O. Solvent is liquid, solute is also liquid. Ethanol dissolving water. And solvent is liquid and solute is solid. Glucose dissolving H2O. The third type of the solution is solid solutions. When in the solution, when solvent is solid and solute is gas, liquid or solid. A common example of solid solutions, when solvent is solid and solute is gas, hydrogen in palladium. Solvent is solid, solute is liquid, amalgam of mercury with sodium. Solvent is solid and solute is also solid. The common example of these types of solution is copper when dissolved in gold. Let's see the expressed in the concentration of the solution. The concentration of the solution is expressed in two methods, qualitatively and quantitatively. In the qualitatively method, we express the solution's concentration in by the concentrated solutions and diluted solution. The concentrated solution is called that solution in which the amount of solute is relatively high And the diluted solution is called that types of solution in which the amount of solute is relatively low. But these types of descriptions create lot of confusions in daily life. So we require or we need to quantitatively expressing the concentration of the solutions, and the concentration of the solutions expressing in the quantitatively by these types of descriptions. First, mass percentage, which is denoted by weight by weight, volume percentage, which is denoted by volume, mass by volume percentage, which is denoted by W, parts per million, mole fractions, molarity, which is denoted by capital M, and molality, which is denoted by the small m. Now we see the individually. First is mass percentage, which is denoted by weight. The concentration of the solutions expressing in mass percentage weight by weight is mass of the component in the solutions upon total mass of the solutions into 100. For example, 10% weight by weight glucose solution in water means 10 gram of glucose dissolved in 90 gram of water. The concentration of the solution expressing mass percentage is commonly used in industrial chemical application. Second is volume percentage. Second is volume percentage. The volume percentage of component in the solution is defined as the volume of the component in the solutions upon total volume of the solution into 100. For example, 10% volume by volume solutions of ethanol in H2O means 10 ml of ethanol dissolved in 19 ml of H2O. Solution coexisting liquids are commonly expressed in this unit. For example, 30% volume by volume ethylene glycol and an antifreeze is used in car for cooling the engine. Third is mass by volume percentage, which is denoted by W upon V. 10% mass by volume percentage solutions of salt in H2O means 10 gram of salt dissolved in 100 ml of H2O. This unit commonly used in medicine and pharmacy. Fourth is parts per million. The expressing concentration of the solutions parts per million is equal to numbers of parts of the components upon total numbers of parts of all components of the solution into 10^6. When a solute is present in trace quantities, it is convenient to express concentration in parts per million, which is also denoted in short form by the ppm. Fifth is mole fractions. Mole fraction is equal to numbers of moles of a component upon total numbers of moles of all components. And mole fraction of solvent plus mole fraction of solute is equal to 1. Sixth is molarity. Molarity, capital M. Molarity is equal to moles of solute upon volume of solutions in liters. Means how many number of solute is present in the volume of solution in liter. 7 is molality, small m. Molality is equal to number of moles of solute per mass of the solvent in kg. Now let's see some problems on the basis of expressing concentration of the solute. First problem, calculate the mass percentage of benzene and carbon tetrachloride if 22 gram of benzene is dissolved in 122 gram of carbon tetrachloride in CCl4. Now, mass percentage of component is equal to mass of component in solution upon total mass of the solution into 100. Mass of benzene is equal to 22 grams. And mass of the carbon tetrachloride is equal to 122 grams. Mass of benzene is equal to 22 grams and mass of the carbon tetrachloride is 122 grams. Now mass percentage of component is equal to mass of component in solution upon total mass of solution. Total mass of solutions, mass of the component is 22 grams upon total mass of the component is 22 plus 122 into 100 is equal to 1.278%. Mass percentage component means benzene. Hence, mass percentage component means benzene is equal to mass of component in solution upon total mass of the solution. Mass of component in solution is 22 gram and total mass of the solution is 22 plus 122 into 100 is equal to 15.278%. And mass percentage of CCl4 is equal to 100 minus 278 is equal to 2%. Second problem, calculate the mole fractions of benzene in solution containing 30% weight by weight in CCl4. Here we find out to calculate the mole fraction of benzene. So mole fraction of benzene is equal to mole of benzene plus mole of benzene plus mole of CCl4. So we first find out the mole of benzene and mole of CCl4. Here given 30% weight by weight in CCl4 means 30% solution weight by weight solution of CC benzene in carbon tetrachloride means 30 C6H6 dissolved in 70 gram CCl4 and number of moles of benzene is equal to given mass upon molar mass. Given mass 30 and molar mass 78. Molinos is equal to 0.385 mole. Here we calculate the mole fractions of benzene. Mole fraction of benzene is equal to mole of benzene upon mole of benzene plus mole of carbon tetrachloride. Now, first we find out the number of moles of benzene and number of moles of CCl4 carbon tetrachloride. And here also given 30% weight by weight solutions of benzene in carbon tetrachloride and 30% weight by weight solutions of benzene in carbon tetrachloride means 30 gram of benzene dissolved in 70 gram of CCl4 and number of moles of benzene is equal to given mass upon molar mass and given mass is 30 gram so 30 gram upon 78 gram this is molar mass of the benzene so we obtain the number of moles of benzene is 0.385 moles. And as it is number of moles of CCl4 is equal to given mass upon molar mass. Given mass 70 gram and molar mass 154 gram is equal to 0.455. This is the number of moles of carbon tetrachloride. Number of moles of benzene is equal to 0.385 and 0.455 number of moles of carbon tetrachloride. Now mole fraction of C6H6 is equal to 0.385 upon 0.385 plus 0.455 is equal to 0.458 and mole fraction of CCl4 is equal to 0.455 upon 0.455 plus 0.385 is equal to 0.542. This is the mole fraction of benzene and this is the mole fraction of carbon tetrachloride. The mole fraction of CCl4 also find out in another method in which 1 minus mole fraction of C6H6 is equal to 1 minus 0.458 is equal to 0.542. Third problem. Calculate molality of 2.5 gram of ethanoic acid CA3COOH in 75 gram of benzene. Here given mass of acetic acid C3COOH is equal to 2.5 gram, mass of benzene is equal to 75 gram. Now molality is equal to mass of the number of moles of solute upon mass of solvent in kg. Now moles is equal to given mass upon molar mass. So given mass is 2.5 gram and molar mass of acetic acid is equal to 60 gram mole inverse is equal to 0.0417. Number of moles of solute is equal to 0.0417. Now mass of the solvent in kg, mass of the solvent in 70, here given 75 gram, so 75 gram is equal to 0.075 kg, hence mass of the solvent in kg is equal to 0.075. Hence answer is 0.556 gram kg inverse. This is the answer. Fourth problem, calculate the molarity of a solution containing 5 gram of NOH in 450 ml solution. Here given mass of NOH is equal to mass of NH is equal to 5 gram and volume of solution is equal to 450 ml. Now molarity is equal to moles of solute upon volume of solution in liter. Now moles of solute is equal to given mass upon molar mass. Given mass 5 gram and molar mass 40 gram mole inverse, 0.125 mole. Hence moles of solute is equal to 0.125 upon volume of solution is equal to 450 ml is equal to 0.45 liter, hence 0.45. so answer is 0.278.